that is with us this week. But before we go any further, it is important that we recognize the sponsor of this convention. That is the Farm Credit Services of Midland. And at this time, we would like to show you what the Farm Credit Services of Midland does. Do for other people. They donate $7,500, just for this convention to represent, to serve 11,173 Iowa FFA members. They deserve another round of applause. To start this session off right, it is only fit that we take a moment to give thanks to the one who has made everything possible for all of us here. For this evening's invocation, I am pleased to introduce a person who led the Iowa FFA Association with an everlasting dream in mind. Last year's state FFA president, Mr. Paul C. Hansen. Please join me in welcoming him to the stage. Well, it was kind of odd to see myself up on that stage last year, reading a sheet of paper again, but this time to change 9 people's lives. And I'm honored to be able to come back here tonight and to begin this convention off with the invocation. So if you'll all please assume an attitude of prayer. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for allowing all of us safe travel together here at the 69th State Leadership Conference. As we begin this conference, we ask for your strength to be with the state officers as they finish the year of leadership for the FFA. And to be with the new chapters chartered here tonight as they get started, as well as those chapters honored for their 50th anniversary. We give you praise, Lord, for providing all the contestants of the conference with the skills and the talents to perform here. And we also ask that you be with all of the members as they develop into the future agricultural leaders. As the title of this session suggests, we hope, Lord, that you provide the path for all members to be able to go forth for the blue and the gold. In your name we pray. Amen. Paul, you have not only served the 11,000 FFA members last year, but you set a precedence. A precedence for us, this year's state officer team, to try to accomplish. You deserve, you've earned, and you need a lot more. And I present you with this appreciation plaque for all that you do for us and also for me. Thank you. FFA members, this past year has been very exciting. It has had times to remember, times for the state officers to meet FFA members from around the state. But this year has also been a year of many accidents and many misfortunes. At this time, I would like the auditorium to take a mood and a moment of silence for all of the FFA members that passed away this past year. Thank you. There are many groups and organizations that come to the city of Des Moines every year. And every year, the FFA comes to Des Moines, comes to Veterans Memorial Auditorium to celebrate a year of success. But FFA members, as we take city of Des Moines with these blue corduroy jackets, there is always one business, one person that makes sure that our journey to Des Moines is totally full of entertainment, full of tours, full of opportunities. At this time, FFA members, please give me a warm welcome to the Director of Sales for the Greater Des Moines Convention and Visitors Bureau, Mr. Paul Holliday.
Good evening and welcome to Des Moines. We are honored to host the 69th Leadership Conference. As he's indicated, we work closely with your leadership in the housing, finding hotels, and also in lining up some of these great tours. And by the way, there are only two tours that are left open, and that's the Iowa Farm Bureau and the your Iowa FFA Foundation. So I urge you to sign up for them right away before the tickets are gone. This afternoon, I was visiting with one of my a banker friend downtown on the Skywalk, and I was telling her that I was going to be speaking to the FFA tonight, and she said, "Oh yes, those wonderful kids with the blue jackets." And then she went on to say, "You know, they set the standard by which we judge all the other youth groups that come to Des Moines." And that's a pretty strong compliment, and I think you ought to feel proud that you are judged in that respect. We're honored again to have you. We want you to enjoy your stay. But let's put out an FFA challenge for these other youth groups for next year. And since you're the standard by which they're judged, let's raise the bar just a little bit higher. Okay? Have a great time.
Mr. Holliday, as you have opened up your arms and allowed the over 2,500 FFA members here today come into the city of Des Moines, you don't have to worry about it one bit. But this group of FFA members will raise the bar more than that, and then some, because we are here to represent the largest and the best youth organization in this nation. And on behalf of the Iowa FFA Association, here's a token of our appreciation. Let's give Mr. Holliday a round of applause. Just as the beginning of this session, we came running down that aisleway over there as newly elected officers. Back in November, there was a new set of officers elected to lead the National FFA Organization into the 1997-98 year. Down in Kansas City, as we sat there watching them so eagerly to hear their name called, one man's name was called. Before I introduce this next national officer, let me just tell you this. Mr. Charlie Jones is one of the most electrifying national officers that I have ever met. And as he enters the podium, FFA members, give him a round of applause.
Good evening, Iowa FFA. It is indeed an honor for me to be here today. I just want to tell you, I've got a little contest going on this year that I want to find the loudest group of FFA members in the country. Now, I've got one state right now that is just tearing everybody else up. No one has even come close. So, I want to give you the opportunity to compete in this contest. Iowa FFA, how do you feel? All the pride you've got in your chapter, all the pride that you've got in this convention, all the pride you've got in your state. And I want to hear, Iowa FFA, how do you feel?
Thank you.
the opportunity to drive around with Mr. Grant Belding. And we were going down the road, and we came up on his car wreck. And I looked over at Grant, and I said, I wonder what happened. And Grant said, well, you know, I know some of those police officers over there. Let's stop and find out. So we got out of the car, and we walked up to where the police officers were standing at. And we noticed they were all huddled in a little group. Now, there was a father, a mother, and two little children that were in this wreck, but they had been taken off to the hospital already. But all the officers were huddled in this little group, and we didn't know who they were talking to. It looked like they were writing something down. So we came up there, and we leaned in real close, and we noticed that there was a monkey in between these officers. And these police officers were sitting there looking at this monkey. And one of them looked at the monkey and said, well, you know, everybody's been taken to the hospital, so who are we going to find out what happened in this wreck? So one of the officers got the bright idea, and he looked at the monkey and said, monkey, he said, what were the kids doing during this wreck? The monkey said, oh, kids fighting. That's a classic call of a wreck. Said, monkey, so what was the wife doing? The monkey said, it is indeed a pleasure to be here, to be in your presence at the Iowa FFA Leadership Conference, one of the most exciting leadership conferences I've ever heard about. I want to thank you for the opportunity to be here. We're going to have a great week. Keep that enthusiasm. Let's raise the roof in this place.
Charlie, I know definitely for sure that this congregation of the 1997 members that are here at the 69th Iowa FFA State Leadership Conference will never forget you and forget your enthusiasm. And so I stress, FFA members, get a chance to visit with Charlie Jones. And as I present him with his conference t-shirt of Racing Towards the Vision, let's give him a round of applause. Personal growth and career success that every FFA member will gain in their agricultural education courses. At this time, it is with my honor and with high honor to present these schools with a new charter for their new FFA chapter. Madam Secretary, please read the names of these new FFA chapters.
They are as follows. The Baxter FFA chapter. The Gilbert FFA chapter. And the Food, Agricultural, and Mechanical FFA chapter.
Inside of me, a jittery feeling. A feeling where I can understand the trials, the tribulations that that group went through. They have made 50 years a golden anniversary. The reason it is golden, because it is extremely special, something that very few reach without success. Tonight we'll present 9 chapters of Golden Anniversary Certificates, sponsored by the Cenex Foundation as a special project of the Iowa FFA Foundation. Madam Secretary, please read the names of these Golden Anniversary chapters.
As I read your chapter's name, will you please step forward? Chapters earning the Golden Anniversary Award include the following: is Gladys Weinbeck FFA Chapter of Rhinebeck, is Diamond Trail FFA Chapter of Monroe, the MFL Marvin FFA Chapter of Monona, the South Hamilton FFA Chapter of Jewel, the Arizona FFA Chapter,
seen 9 50th anniversary chapters. I encourage each one of you to go home, check your history. I'm sure most of you have reached that golden anniversary point, the point where you have reached premier success, that golden anniversary. FFA members, it has been an extreme honor of mine to serve on this team of state officers. This team of state officers has more heart, more drive, and more passion to serve the 11,173 of you, the Iowa FFA members. It is a time where we are going to hear one retiring address. Each state officer will have a chance to do that at this conference, but at this time, I will call upon Dustin Ford and Reed Hawkinson for an introduction of a retiring address. Please give them a warm welcome as they enter the stage.
Sets a standard for leadership, dedication, and enthusiasm for FFA in the state of Iowa.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lisa Herring shows both courage and dedication as she achieves her highest aspirations. By serving leading the members of the Iowa FFA organization, she has climbed the highest mountain. Without any further ado, I introduce to you both our friend and our hero, your 1996-1997 North Central District State Vice President, Lisa Herring.
Finally, it was time. Time to go outside and play in the
snow to friends and neighbors, brothers and sisters. You spend countless hours building snowmen, making snow forts, and having those great snowball fights. But what about the game that we all loved? King of the Mountain. Do you remember when we were so little? That mountain looked so big to us. So much work and effort went into climbing it. Sometimes as we were climbing, we'd find ourselves slipping, falling backwards fast. Sometimes we even find ourselves at the bottom of the mountain, right back where we had started. So much work and effort had gone into that, but you're still back where you began. FFA members, whether you realize it or not, what may seem like a childish game to us now is a game that we play with ourselves every day. Did you every day a challenge is put forth ahead of you? Did you choose to climb your mountain? Or did you choose to stay at the bottom? FFA members, I know that each and every one of you sitting out there today can look up near the horizon and see a mountain that you love to climb. Can you imagine the view as you stand on top of your mountain? Look around, and you know that you made it to the top. You made it. When I was 6, I had a mountain to climb on my own. Not only was it time to start kindergarten, but I had other problems other than just dealing with school. For you see, I had a speech problem. From the time I was 6 till I was in 4th grade, I went through extensive speech therapy. Nobody could understand me except for my parents. FFA members, not only did I have to deal with the troubles of learning how to speak correctly, but I had to deal with my friends and my peers making fun of me. FFA members, it has been a long, hard road up my mountain, but today I'm standing on top of it. I believe there are many keys to our success in climbing your mountain. The first one is to find your mountain. Every day, our society wants us to become a professional basketball player, a painter or actress, and a millionaire. Where are your talents? Seek those talents out, whether it be FFA, speech, academics, or sports. Find the mountain that is truly yours. The second key to climbing your mountain is to take a risk. Risk can be a very scary thing, and we must put our hopes and our dreams on the line to achieve what may seem impossible to us. You must take a risk. Sometimes we might find ourselves falling down that mountain. Start back up. So what? Either you may need to find an alternative path, or maybe you just need to believe in yourself. Amanda Bradley said it best. Believe in yourself, what you think, what you feel. Believe in the truth, the good, the ideal. Believe that your dreams can someday become real. Forever and always, believe. Believe in yourself and what you can do. Believe in the goals that you strive to pursue. Believe in the friends that believe in you too. Forever and always, believe. FFA members, I believe that is so important. I know that each and every one of you can climb your mountain. You only believe in yourself. When you reach the top of the mountain, you may feel that your task is complete. In music, one single note can create a melody, such as this. How many of us enjoy listening to a song that just has a melody? What truly makes a song sweet is all the accompaniment parts and the harmony. Create an orchestra. FFA members, when you reach the top of the mountain, look around, enjoy the view, and walk back down that mountain and help someone else up it. Only then will your accomplishment be as sweet. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the people in my life that have created my harmonies. Mom, Dad, Renee, and Brad. Thank you, and I love you so very much. Thank you for setting me free to tackle my own mountains and to strive for excellence. To Mr. Friesen, I'd like to think that you gave me the music, the trail map to outline my path. I can never thank you enough, but thanks for being my friend, too. To my best friends, Reed, Dustin, and Eric, thank you for always being there. You will always have a special melody in my heart. To my district officers, Grant, Dustin, Annie, Allison, and Cliff, thank you. I'm so very proud of you. And finally, to my team, and Mr. O'Neill, thanks for the wonderful memories this year. I will never forget our year together. And finally, FFA members, I want to thank you, the over 11,000 FFA members of this great state of Iowa. Thank you for the gifts that you have given me this year. Not material, but by the looks in your eyes and smiles on your faces. I can only hope that I was able to give something back to you and back to this great organization. Finally, FFA members, I challenge you to dream. Climb your mountain, create your harmonies, be the harmony for others, then climb the next mountain. Only then will you truly be the king of your world.
Yes, Mr. President, I have some urgent announcements. Will the following people
please come to the back side of the stage at this time. A representative from Wapello, Algona, and West Branch. Will Michael Reed from the Marengo FFA chapter, Carrie Gaskell from the Lake Mills FFA chapter, Luke Wells from the Guthrie Center FFA chapter, Jill Phillips from the Montezuma FFA chapter, Greg Reed from the Marengo FFA chapter, Andy Beeland from St. Ansgar, a representative from Eddyville, an additional representative from St. Ansgar, Andrea Lemke from Mid Prairie, Alex Olson from Lake Mills, Carla Lemke from Adair, Rebecca Hyman from Rockwell City, and representative from Harlan, Anamosa, and Orient Maxburg. Those are all the announcements I have at this time.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. As I have traveled throughout my life, ever since the age of 8, I have had the great opportunity to work with a company that exemplifies serving its members and providing an outstanding future for agriculture. That is the Growmark Cooperative. This cooperative started a program that has been growing in participation as well as availability in a few select central states. Those few states that participate in this Growmark Essay Contest. This is sponsored by the Growmark Incorporated. This event encourages FFA members to broaden their horizons on agricultural issues and stimulates and brings ideas for those FFA members searching for new and exciting ways of agriculture that is available in this future. At this time, could you please help me welcome one of the greatest individuals that is a friend of the FFA, Mr. John Croft, to the podium, please. We will now hear a few comments from Mr. Croft for the Growmark Corporation. Please give him another round of applause real quick.
Thank you, Grant. You know, it's really quite something to stand here in front of you because I know you're there and I've met you and I've talked with you, but I can't see you. I just want to say there are two things that I would like to emphasize, and that is thanks to the ag teachers that every day help you accomplish the things you do and ask you to stretch yourselves. The second is thank you to everyone who participated. You are all winners.
At this time, I'd like to call on the Madam Secretary to please read the names of the Growmark members.
Mr. President, the following are the top 25 participants in the Growmark contest. Jared Reichert from the New Hampton FFA chapter. Alex Smith from the Red Oak FFA chapter. Thank you.
Let's give those award winners one more round of applause, and Thomas continue for winning this award. Sometimes when a conference goes on, you never know who is the one doing the behind-the-scenes work. Well, throughout this past year, Mr. John Crump has been more than just a person that's helped us backstage. When we went to the GrowMark Conference in Chicago, Illinois, he was a person that helped me push, to be passionate, to say what's in your heart whenever you give a speech. Mr. John Croft has given heart, passion to the FS Corporation, to GrowMark Corporation, and to the FFA. He is a true individual that has blue and gold going through his veins. FFA members, please give Mr. John Croft a round of applause. As the state officers travel throughout this great nation, there are so many times when we get to see other individuals that are state officers along with us and become true friends throughout our journeys. Many of our experiences are the same, but many of our experiences are different, to where we can help each other prepare for the future to better serve you, the FFA members. Today, we are so fortunate to have state associations from the Midwest and from the East Coast. At this time, I would like to call each of the associations to come forward to the podium and I ask to read their names and where they're from.
On behalf of the South Dakota FFA Association, I, Travis Sherman, am happy to be here for this great conference.
And I, Ryan Kamak from the South Dakota Association, also are very excited to be here at the 69th Iowa State Leadership Conference.
Hi, I'm Wendy Schumpfer. I'm from the Illinois Association, and I'm happy to be here in Iowa.
Hello, I'm Hunt Macy, the CFA President from the great state of Land of Lincoln. And I'll congratulate all the award winners tonight and wish you a great convention. Thank you.
Greetings on behalf of the North Carolina FFA Association. I am Robbie Manning, the State Vice President. I met Grant back in January and he said that you all were very enthusiastic and he wasn't kidding. I look forward to the rest of this conference. Thank you.
At this time, as I present each one of these state associations with a conference t-shirt, once again, let's show the excitement to these other states what the Iowa FFA members have and what their members should have. Who got us to a certain point in our lives. I know for me, there are so many times throughout my life that I refer back to my family, to my friends, and to the people that got me to where I'm at today. In the FFA, sometimes there are so many things that we can do, so many opportunities, and so many places that you can go. The FFA has developed a program to establish role models and also heroes for individuals to look up to. The Project PALS mentoring program is quickly growing across this nation. This program concentrates on being a hero and a pal to an elementary student who needs that positive influence that the FFA offers to its students. This PALS program not only helps the individual, but helps the community. Because as those leaders are made and formed, so is the community grown and prosper. Madam Secretary, please read the names of the chapters who now have established Pals Program and are making a positive difference in our community.
Mr. President, the following chapters are being recognized because they have recently implemented a Pals Program with their FFA chapters. The Colfax Mingo FFA Chapter of Colfax. Davis County FFA at Bloomfield. Macoupin Valley FFA Chapter at Belfast. The Eggflower FFA Chapter of Eddyville. The North Scott FFA Chapter at Elbridge. The Gladstone Rhine FFA Chapter at Rhine. The Wapsie Valley.
To the PALS program. This next year, this next spring actually, the Blue Cross and Blue Shield will be sponsoring a PALS training workshop through the Iowa FFA Foundation to strengthen this mentoring program all across Iowa. FFA members, if you want to make a difference, if you want to be a hero in some elementary student's life, get a hold of your ag advisor, get a hold of the Iowa FFA advisor, and they will give you the date and the time when this workshop will be going on, where you can make an impact in the future. Madam Secretary, do you have any announcements at this time?
I have none, Mr. President.
Earlier tonight, we heard a very moving retiring address from Lisa Ahrens. But as each of these days go on, a state officer will give a retiring address and one is down. This next retiring address goes to an individual that is extremely inspiring and has made a difference in the FFA throughout this year. At this time, I would like to call upon Trissa Hyde and Amanda James for a special introduction for a retiring address.
Buzz Lightyear, Space Ranger, Universe Protection Unit. My ship has crash landed here by mistake. Yes, it is a mistake, because you see, the bed here is my spot.
I need to repair my turbo boosters. Do people still use fossil fuels, or have you discovered crystallic fusion?
Well, let's see. We got double A's.
Watch yourself. Boom. Bob, who goes there?
Don't you, Bob.
Okay, friends.
Do you know these life forms?
Yes. They're Andy's toys.
All right, everyone, you're clear to come up. I am Buzz Lightyear. I come in peace.
Oh, I'm so glad you're not a dinosaur.
Thank you. No, thank you all for your
We're all a part of one big toy story. Yes, each and every one of you here, whether you're sitting, standing, or sleeping, are part of an exciting show, FFA Story. You see, it all began when you landed on strange, unstable ground as you entered the FFA. You were greeted by people who you never met before. You stood your ground as some tried to discourage you, while some encouraged you. Look at you now. Somehow, however, you earned your way here to the 69th State FFA Leadership Conference. 1 year ago, my turn began. I was elected to lead on strange, unstable ground to serve as your 1996-97 State FFA reporter. Due to all the encouragement that I received from you, family, and God, I have completed what I consider a successful year as not only a reporter, but also as a member of the Iowa FFA Association team. Throughout the movie Toy Story, Woody the Sheriff stressed that Buzz was just a toy. But Buzz was determined to prove him wrong, to prove he was someone sent on a mission. FFA members, I challenge you to prove to your friends, family, advisor, community, and especially yourself, that you are not just an FFA member. You are the next CEO, head mechanic, farmer, or whatever path you choose to follow. In Buzz Lightyear's mission statement, he stated, I'm stationed in the Camera Quadrant of Sector 4 as a member of the Elite Universal Protection Unit of the Space Ranger Corps. I protect the galaxy from the threat of invasion from the evil Emperor Zurg, sworn enemy of the Galactic Alliance. Here is my mission statement. I'm stationed in the FFA as a member of the Elite Universal Leadership Unit of the FFA Association Corps. I encourage today's young people to take advantage of opportunities afforded them and are publicized in hopes of agriculture. I also protect FFA members from the threat of invasion from the evil Emperor Unemployment, sworn enemy of the FFA Galactic Alliance. As a result of my mission statement, I hope to have made a difference in your lives, whether it be encouragement to become an FFA member or a compliment on how well you're doing. My year of service has been one accomplishment, but it could not have happened without your help. FFA members, you may not know this, but you have had an impact on my life. As a new friend, an encourager, or just an acquaintance, you have not only given me a year of memories, you have given me a reason for living and serving this wonderful organization. As my year of service comes to a close, I'd like to recognize some people who have had an impact on my life. Mom, Dad, Grandma, Grandpa, thank you for your endless love and encouragement throughout the past 19 years of my life, and especially throughout this past year. My brothers, Brady, Bob, and Matt, for serving as role models, and especially Philip, for making sure that animals were taken care of in my absences. My best friend, Eric, for lending an ear when needed, and giving me an insight to life that I never had before. The President FFA chapter for giving me 5 years of wonderful leadership activities and enduring me especially. My fellow officers for giving me 1 year of outstanding leadership, friendship, and unbelievable happiness. My FFA advisor, Mr. Zuboff, for teaching me that 99% effort isn't enough, 100% is. And last, but surely not least, each and every one of you, the FFA members, for giving me the opportunity to serve you this past year. FFA members, I encourage you to obtain a personal mission statement in hopes that you will not only improve your own life and reach your own set of goals, but that you can help another along the way as they set out to achieve their own set of goals. I hope that you will grasp that goal, which will allow you to reach your dream of not being just an FFA member. A set of goals which will allow you to stretch your imagination to infinity and beyond.
Manson Northwest Webster.
G&G FFA chapter. And the reserve champion team, the Agricultural Sales CDB, was the Osage FFA chapter. Winning the Ag Sales Spring Valley event was the Northeast Goose Lake FFA chapter at Goose Lake.
Would Lindsay Spira and Amy Peterson from the Prairie Valley FFA please report backstage at this time?
FFA members and guests, let's give those Ag Sales Career Development Event Result winners another round of applause. In the FFA, we have a lot of events that help the members, individuals, and teams to gain the characteristics to make them better and more valuable for the future. The events help recruit members in the FFA are those that help better the FFA member. This is done through the Experience and Action Career Development Event. This event was created 3 years ago to promote recruitment in activities at the chapter level. This is sponsored by the Mintex Citrus Company through the Iowa FFA Foundation. And at this event, they receive cash and plaques. Let's give our sponsor a round of applause at this time. Secretary, please enlighten us on the top chapters in this area.
The top three chapters in the Experience the Action CDB. In third, the West Branch FFA chapter. Second, the Wabamo FFA chapter. And first in the Experience the Action CDE, the Algoma FFA chapter. The Experience the Action contest. A round of
with the agricultural industry changing every day, as new technology comes out and new phases of genetics and other agricultural industries change to fit the better need of agriculture, we must be ready to face this kind of a change in the industry. To help FFA members better understand these agricultural issues, we have an Iowa FFA Ag Discussion Meeting was established to make sure that we were ready, we were on top of those changes. This event is for the out-of-school FFA members, and this gives them an opportunity for them to get a better understanding of the agricultural industry and its changes. The Ag Discussion Meeting is sponsored by the Iowa Farm Bureau Federation as a part of a continued effort to promote agriculture and the support of the FFA and alumni, FFA in Iowa. The Assistant Field Service Director at the Iowa Farm Bureau is an excellent example of this type of service. This individual helps everyone in Farm Bureau and in the agricultural field understand the changes that are coming about. FFA members, please help me welcome Mr. Darrell Weems to the podium. Madam Secretary, please read the names of the winners of this Ag Discussion Meeting.
The third place individual in the Ag Discussion Meeting was Carrie Gaskell from the Lake Mill FFA chapter. Second place was Michael Reed from the Marengo FFA chapter. And the winner of the Ag Discussion Meeting, Luke Wells from the Boundary Center FFA chapter.
Let's give these participants a round of applause, these winners. to present a token of our appreciation to Mr. Darrell Weems, to a person that I have known all my life. Mr. Weems, you have helped me grow as an individual by working with my parents and by helping me out and understanding the agricultural issues and changes, just as you help FFA members. Thank you. FFA members, please give him a round of applause. There are many careers that people try and succeed in today's society. There are careers that are plundering all over this country and are there for every person to grasp a hold of. In the FFA, we try to get you prepared for all sorts of careers. Through different contacts, through different events, you gain the characteristics to get you ready for those future achievements and possibilities in different jobs. With us tonight to help us present the Ag Broadcasting Journalism Awards from the Iowa Radio Broadcasting Association is Mr. Al Grigg. Let's welcome Mr. Al Grigg to the stage for comments.
Thank you, Grant, and good evening. FFA students, you are the lifeblood of our nation. Communication is a skill that you have developed through FFA. Ag broadcasting is a way that you can communicate to the world the good things about agriculture and agribusiness. All of you involved in ag broadcasting are winners, and we're going to present some special awards.
FFA members, give Mr. Grigg a round of applause at this time. Inform us of the winners of the Ag Broadcasting Journalism Career Development Event.
Yes, I will. The top three individuals on the Ag Broadcasting Journalism CDE. In third, Greg Reed for the Marengo FFA chapter. In second place, Andy Beeman from the St. Andrew FFA chapter. And the top individual is Jim Phillips from the Montezuma FFA chapter. Let's congratulate all of our winners.
Let's give them one round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Al Grigg has been one of those radio broadcasters that has always made an effort to tell the story of the FFA. He has not only wanted to tell the story of the FFA just in one area, just in one little sector of his community. Mr. Al Grigg is the type of person that would travel clear down to Kansas City to get an interview. He would travel all the way to Ames to get an interview. He would go where the story was at and wherever the betterment of the FFA was at to make sure that he told the story of America's leadership for the future. Mr. Albert, here's a token of our appreciation for all that you do for the FFA and the Iowa Radio Broadcasters Association. Please give him a round of applause. It is amazing to see that there are so many people that do not understand the agricultural field. There are so many times when people have perceptions or superstitions about agriculture. 4 years ago, the Ag Issues and Perceptions event was started with a sponsorship from the Iowa chapter of the American Society of Farm Managers and Rural Appraisers as a special project of the Iowa FFA Foundation. This event encourages FFA members to increase their knowledge and awareness of agricultural issues and the general public's perception of these issues. A team of six FFA members role-play various community leaders and debate issues representing all
Here this evening, with us is from the Iowa chapter of American Society of Farm Managers and Rural Appraisers, is Mr. Gary Lyles. Please welcome him as he approaches the podium. Madam Secretary, please read the names of the Ag Issues and Perceptions winners.
The top two teams in the Ag Issues and Perceptions CDE. The second place team is the St. Anne's for FFA chapter.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause for these winners. Mr. Lyles has been a longtime supporter of the FFA. He has also been a visionary leader, racing towards a vision in his business and in the FFA to prepare them for the future. Mr. Lyles, for a token of our appreciation, I want to thank you for sponsoring this event, for bettering the Iowa FFA and also society. FFA members, please give him a round of applause as he gets his token of appreciation. Themselves in a way that can never be taught, but can be experienced and built upon year after year and year. Tonight, we will honor individuals who exemplify these qualities, which each of them have strived for and have succeeded. Each of the winners of the Extemporaneous Public Speaking and the Public Speaking event will receive a $100 check and a certificate from the National FFA Foundation. Madam Secretary, please inform us of these winners.
Ladies and gentlemen, please help me congratulate our 1997 Iowa FFA Public Speaking Alternate, Carla Lemke of the Adair Casey FFA Chapter. And the Public Speaking winner is Rebecca Heiler of the Rockville City Mitten FFA Chapter. Our Speaking Alternate is Andrea Lemke of the McMurray FFA Chapter. And the Extemporary Speaking winner is Alex Olson from the Lake Mills FFA Chapter. Let's show all our winners our appreciation for their tremendous job they've done and congratulate them for their accomplishments.
As State President, I've had a great opportunity to learn a little bit more about parliamentary procedure and learn a little bit more about how a meeting should be run and how a meeting should not be run. Throughout this year, the State Officer Team has had the chance to travel to many different businesses and industries and assist them as parliamentarians and help them in conducting meetings and other events. At this time, I would like to call upon a Maquoketa Valley, a Maquoketa FFA alumni representative who sponsors this through the Iowa FFA Foundation, Mrs. Dawn Ritalik, to come to the stage at this time. FFA members, please give her a round of applause. Madam Secretary, please read the names of these individuals who have won the Parliamentary Procedure Awards.
The top three teams in this year's Parliamentary Procedure Career Development Event. In third, the Orion Master FFA Chapter.
You guys want it for me?
chapter. And the top chapter in this year's Parliamentary Procedure CDE is the Anamosa FFA chapter. Let's congratulate all of these winners.
Thank you.
the G&G FFA chapter, Osage FFA chapter, and the Northeast Deuce Lake FFA chapter. In the Creed speaking career development event, bronze emblems went to Chad Carter of the Walnut FFA, Terry Greenfield of the Northeast Hamilton FFA, Luke Benson from the Lawrence Marathon FFA. Silver emblems went to Don't ever forget how to laugh. will be too proud to cry. It is by doing both that we both will cry to the fullest. Each of us is getting a push from a different direction, whether it's from our parents, our ed advisors, coaches, brothers and sisters, or teachers. But each one of us has a dream, and that dream is to be a star of something. It might be the best singer, it might be to be the best athlete, or maybe it's to get that goal or that contest or professional thing. Each one of us is shooting for the moon. But always remember that when you shoot for the moon, you may miss. You may not meet that ultimate goal. But just remember that you'll always be among the stars. Because just by being involved in this NFA organization, you're showing that you truly are a star. Whether it's in NFA, school, or in life.
Keep the FFA spirit going in your school. She
She let nothing stand in her way. When I went on a chapter visit and visited Amy, I got to experience her enthusiasm for the FFA. We talked to the school board. Amy's persistence shined through, and there is a Fort Myers FFA next year. Her vision proves it all. One life can make a difference.
As this team stands before you, the light shines in front of them. It is not a blind individuality. It's a line that every FFA member is asked to align. I can remember back as a young boy when I would wait in the lawn, wait out some great record inside the lawn area, wait for my dad to get home. When my dad would come home from an hour, he was in a suit or open up just a pair of old gummies, he would grab his baseball mat and we'd go out and we'd play some catch. You know, you never think of the times that you spend together. A playing ball or playing catch really doesn't mean much to some folks. But to me, he made a difference on the aspect of how I look at other people, how I look at life. He always came home. He always thought about others first, no matter what he had going on. FFA members, you are looking at 9 individuals who have sacrificed, who has given everything they have, just like my parents have given me, and just like their parents have given them. 1 year ago, I and us were brought together to serve as one. To lead the Iowa FFA, make an impact, to show the way. As a team, we formed a mission and began a race towards our vision. A vision to touch lives and positively affect others. When we are elected, a year seems like forever. As of now, we're down to only 2 more days to serve together. We, the officers, hope that in some way we've reached you. Because at the end of this conference, our term is over. It will just be a picture on the wall.
Thank you.
record of any further business which should now be transacted.
I have a few announcements. The only awards that can be picked up after this session are the Ag Sales Team's results. That is the only set of results that can be picked up. Also, Pat Kelly from the Belmont FFA chapter needs to call home as soon as possible. Those are all the announcements I have at this time.
Does any member know of any new or unfinished business which should probably come before this meeting? Salute.